somebody that you claim to love, and when somebody, when the people are not telling you that, okay, your baby is wayward though, you not believe just immediately like that, like that.
Focus on me. We're back to our regularly scheduled program,
the Wigs
Mickey Mouse Club
content.
We like your dream, telling you to subscribe.
Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So you guys, today we are not going to be talking about any, I don't think this week I'm going to talk about any movie that Iroko uploaded, because for some reason they didn't resonate with me, like I didn't connect with any of them. So instead I said, let me just watch Ojukwu season 2. I don't know if you guys remember, if you watched my Ojukwu season 1 first impression video, but I watched Ojukwu season 1 like, I want to say last year, like I just finished watching season 2 like yesterday, and I don't know why it took me so long to watch season 2, but you guys, season 2 was way better than season 1. I swear, like this Ojukwu series is actually a very, very good show. I don't know why it's taking them so long to bring out season 3, but they need to do it ASAP. So a couple of things, like you guys know, at the end of season 1, Adanna has already died, and we see that Adanna's ghost is still lingering in the human realm. Adanna's ghost is still lingering, and she does, I don't know, I think she has unfinished business, obviously, because she was killed unjustly, and she still tried to protect her family. And this person, Aku finally realizes that okay, that his sons have been sold into slavery. Because of the way his son was sold into slavery, he now decided to just reform himself and try to be a better person, because you know, he stopped doing the slave trade. Now we finally know why Aku hated Udoka so much, and because of Weruche. As Weruche and Aku were lovers before, and maybe I don't think Udoka knew about it. Then Udoka now went on to marry Weruche, so that's where the beef stemmed from. A lot of things happened in this season too, honestly. Like, I'm even surprised that they could achieve so much in 13 episodes. Irema was able to give a son to Udoka, and I don't even know why they carry this son business on their head like government work. So they made Irema, you know, I don't know. Honestly, the Urema was nice to agree, because she had a whole ass boo that was ready to marry her. And when Nina told her, see, the one thing that annoyed me in this season too was they were doing this, all this. You know how if you watch Korean dramas, you will know what I'm talking about. When they are supposed to speak up, they don't. Like the places where Urema was supposed to say something, she will not say. The places where Ago was supposed to say something, he will not say. And they were not doing this stupid whole assumption game. Like, I was just getting vexed, I swear. Anyway, what I was saying before I went into this Urema and Agu rant. Urema, because of, in order for Udoka to get sons, Ina told Urema that Urema has to go and sleep with some unknown man, so you impregnate her, and then hopefully, I don't know why they just assumed that the first child that Urema would get would be a boy. Like, that assumption was huge. What if it was a girl? Like, not say, oh, then you get pregnant and you give us a son. So, this is not what happened though. Urema now agreed though. She now is gonna break up with Agu. Instead of her to tell Agu the reason, well, I guess you're not supposed to tell Agu, but she now is gonna break up with Agu, and told Agu that she never loved him. So Agu now, when people now tell Agu that Urema was wayward, Agu now believed. I didn't even understand. Like, this is somebody that you claim to love, and when the people are not telling you that, okay, your baby is wayward though, you now believe just immediately like that, like that. But a plus twist now happened when Urema went to go and sleep with the person. The person that now had sex with her in order to give her the son was now Agu. So Urema and Agu aside, Odili is a useless human being. As Odili is a disgrace to people, is just bringing shame to people that their name starts with ODI, like me, for example. Odili is a useless human being, and I'm low-key happy that he ran mad. And one thing I didn't really fancy like that was Udoka's death. I mean, I feel like it was inevitable, it was bound to come, but I don't know, man. You know, he caused it. Man, your wife that has not had any problem with any of your family member or your friend or whatever, that has never said any bad thing about your friend or brother or sister or mother or father, said, will now come, now one day will not be like, be careful of your brother. and they will not even say, let you think about it. Let you think about it in the words of Just Too Funny.
But, wow. Think about it. Think.
You will not be like, no, that's my brother. You never did. Like, your wife, she has never ever said anything like this. But the one time she said it, some of you to take it to heart and listen. SMH. Season two was late. Like the way season two captured me and held my attention all throughout the duration. It wasn't that way for season one. And I don't know. I would love, like, I hope, I really, really hope they continue with this series. Because this series is actually interesting. And I would like to see how it ends. I want to know if Weruche and Aku will, you know, come together somehow. I want to see how Agu will react when he finds out that Urema's son is his. You know, I would like to see the what other Udoka spirits will retaliate against the person that killed him. I like to see what the deal is with Adana's spirit, because Adana's spirit is still lingering and she seems to be protecting her family. So I want to see all these things, and I really hope they continue with this Odiku season 3. Please, y'all should give, this is good content. If you haven't watched it, people should check it out too. If you like all this kind of like cultural movies and setting like the only cultural shows, you will like it. Honestly, it's a very interesting show. I will not even lie to you, like, it is interesting, honestly, and the production is really good too. So if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, this is the time to subscribe. Don't forget to hit that little bell, click the subscribe button, and don't forget to tell me what you think, like and share. Thank you, bye.